So sleepy this morning.
So I wanted to take a couple minutes to talk about perfectionism, specifically as it relates to being an artist. I don't know if I know a single artist who doesn't have perfectionist tendencies. It is something that it just naturally comes with the interest of art. And not just like fine artists, but like singers and dancers and anyone who does like a creative pursuit. I feel like many of them can fall to the struggles of being a perfectionist. Being a perfectionist is not inherently a bad thing. I think being a perfectionist has a lot of really, really valuable aspects to it. It's just when it goes overboard as a trait, it can very much damage you, your mental health, and your ability to create. It can actually completely hinder your ability. Which kind of seems counterintuitive, but it's so true once I explain it. Let me explain. Sorry, Mindy. Here's why perfectionism can be a really great thing for you as an artist. It pushes you to strive for excellence, right? Your expectations of yourself force you to go over and above on tasks or creations, which is great. Perfectionists often have a really keen eye for details and getting all the tiny, tiny little aspects of, especially like realist painters and artists. Perfectionists in those categories or genres of art really can excel in making masterpieces. So being a perfectionist as an artist isn't necessarily a bad thing. But what you have to be careful about is the downsides of perfectionism as an artist. So, and I, just so you know, I struggle with perfectionism too. It is something that I, like everybody struggles with. It is so common for artists to struggle with perfectionism, for you to so harshly judge yourself for your imperfections or the imperfections in your art. And also, it kind of goes from your own like personal life into your art, so like your perfectionism. If you think you're just a perfectionist in art, you're probably having perfectionism problems within other aspects of your life as well. So the thing about being a perfectionist is that no matter what you do, even if what you made is 99% correct, you're still gonna feel like a failure. You're still gonna feel like you could have done better. You can make the most beautiful painting anyone's ever seen in their life, but like the top little corner has the tiniest little blemish of a smudge on it, and you will feel like it's ruined, it's done for forever. Not only that, you not feeling satisfied with the end result of something that really is probably very beautiful. Perfectionism can also prevent you from creating in the first place. If you're scared to make mistakes, that you're gonna mess up, that it's not gonna turn out well, you might not even start painting or drawing or singing or whatever you're gonna do. So like, talk about major roadblock. Don't ask me why. And this totally happens to me. I will paint something and I will get dissatisfied with one aspect of it. I don't like the overall color. I don't like how this corner turned out. I don't like how the highlights look, blah, 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 blah. If you let those feelings run rampant, you're gonna feel so icky about something really cool that you made, or you're not even gonna start at all. This, I feel like, for beginners is more so an issue. Beginner perfectionists. So you're coming into art with already a perfectionist mindset, and you see people making things and you see these tutorials and you don't even bother to start or to try, or you already are like, this is too hard, and you don't even go for it because you're too scared to make a mistake. That is literally the biggest creativity killer. I cannot think of a bigger creativity killer than being scared of making mistakes. Like, creativity's all about getting messy. What did Miss Frizzle say? Remember? You have to be okay with making mistakes. Because really, mistakes aren't that bad. Everyone's so scared of them, but like, it's so natural. So just like, that is the most human thing I could possibly think of, is making mistakes. Why not just let yourself create? Why not let yourself enjoy doing something? I feel like there's this like mentality, and I don't know if this is like a modern social media thing or if this is just like an ongoing thing throughout all of humanity, but if you have a hobby, I feel like there's this pressure that you have to be like super good at it or else you can't claim it as a hobby. But I think it's dumb. I think that's stupid. It's just dumb. I think that's stupid. Because I think a hobby should be you doing anything that you enjoy doing. You don't have to be crazy good or be able to monetize your creative pursuits to do them, to enjoy them. Why not just paint for the sake of painting and enjoy the mistakes, all of the struggles and stuff that comes with it? Painting is a lot more about the process than it is about the end result, and I think people forget that sometimes. I feel like it's easy to forget. I think it's really easy to forget because painting, a lot of times, especially with artists that we love and we follow, we see the end result. Like on Instagram, you scroll through Instagram, I have so many beautiful, amazing artists that I follow. All you see is the most perfect, beautiful paintings you've ever seen. What you don't see is the process getting there. You do sometimes. That's why I really love time-lapse videos and why I got into making time-lapse videos of me painting, because the process is so much more satisfying and so much more of the purpose of art as a hobby tool than it is about being able to brag to your friends about this cool thing you made. Which honestly, it's, and I'm not gonna bash on that because I love being able to show somebody something I made and for them to be like, Emily, that's beautiful. But I also don't want that to be my driving motivator for creating. I wanna do it because I enjoy it, and letting go of my perfectionist tendencies is gonna let me enjoy that process. If I hold on to perfectionism, the whole painting is gonna be a slog, it's gonna be miserable, and I might get to the end and then I might hate it still. Like, perfectionism, for all its benefits, which it does have benefits, you just need to be aware of how it can damage you. Especially if you're an artist, especially if you're an artist. Obviously this is geared towards artists because that's my channel, obviously. If you are a perfectionist, it's really hard to let go of that entirely. I don't think perfectionists will ever entirely let go of their perfectionism, and I don't think they should. I think there's a lot of great things about perfectionism that need to be held on to, but if you wanted to tone down some of those bad perfectionist tendencies, the first thing that I would do, and which has helped me, is acknowledgement. Recognize when you are being a perfectionist, when you're being too harsh on yourself, when you're being hypercritical of your abilities, of your work, of even careful people around you. Like, that is the worst kind of perfectionist, when you're perfectioning other people around you. Then you're just an asshole. Knock that one off first. None of that. But when you recognize when you're starting to be hypercritical, that's the first step to shifting your mentality. Because as soon as you start recognizing it, you can be like, oh, hey, that's the mentality that has done me damage in the past, that is unhealthy for me, that is gonna prevent me from creating. As soon as you start recognizing it and then attribute it to being like, hey, that's not the best way for me to think, very slowly over time, you'll be able to let yourself let go of that perfectionism. And instead of going into your usual rabbit hole of being like, this sucks, I suck, I'm gonna throw this out, blah, before you fall into that pit of hating yourself about it, you can be like, eh, mistakes happen, I'm gonna keep going. Or, eh, mistakes happen, I'm a little frustrated, I'm gonna step away for a bit and come back. Don't let it stop you. Do not let your perfectionism stop you. You don't have to stop being a perfectionist, but you need to stop your perfectionism from controlling your art and your life. This is a little bit of a letter to myself, but I used to be far more of a perfectionist than I am now, but recognizing that I was a perfectionist and recognizing in the ways that it was actually hurting me, I've been, over time, a lot better at letting myself be me. It's why I feel comfortable enough to make videos. It's why I feel comfortable enough to share my art on Instagram, because fuck perfection, fuck it! Fuck it! Fuck being perfect. Sorry for the language, children, but fuck it. Being perfect is, one, impossible, and two, boring. It's boring. Imperfections show our humanity in so many ways. I'm not a camera. And I don't want to be a camera. And there are people who, like, you know, realist artists who make beautiful, hyper-realistic things and their paintings look like photographs, and I'm not doubting that at all. I think that's a wonderful thing. But I don't need my art to be perfect. I want it to be human and interesting and fun and make me happy. Like, that's it. That's my letter to all you perfectionists out there, because I don't want that to stop you. So many comments in my videos that people leave are about how theirs turned out terrible, how my painting is better than theirs, how it's too hard, how just all these things, like bashing on themselves unnecessarily in the comments. Honey, honey, it's okay. You don't have to be perfect. Nobody does. I'm not, you're not, and that's great. That's not true, Bindi is perfect. I'm so sleepy this morning, oh my gosh. Things for you to think about today. That's it. That's what I wanted to say. Don't stress. I'll see you in the next video.